Hey guys, this is TechnoGeek Reviews, and this is what I wanted to do for fun, just so you guys may know why I reviewed all the Spider-Man films. And plus, yesterday was the 15th anniversary of the first Sam Raimi Spider-Man movie. I have to say that without these films, I wouldn't have read. Let me show you guys. The original classic run, the first 10 issues of it, and I also like a whole trade, like single issue box full of Spidey comics in there, but that's a pain to take out, and I have the movies right there, and I have to place the box there and slowly show you each one of my comic books that I have. But I can, if you guys request of seeing my Spider-Man comics, I will show you a whole box devoted to the character. Why Spider-Man is a hero that is important to me and impacted me in my life. Spider-Man is a character like Netflix Daredevil with a tad bit better luck. When I tend to describe Daredevil, I tend to describe like Spider-Man but with worse luck. The reason why I've loved all these movies, I'm explaining each one. Like Eminem music when I was a kid, I used to got bullied when I was a kid. I eventually even became a bully at some point. When I was young and life was beating me up, these movies, Spider-Man 1 and Spider-Man 2, provided great escapism through it, and I saw him at the time as more quippy, and I saw his love interest Mary Jane as non-toxic and very good, well-rounded relationship. But it was only till I got older I got to notice the flaws within the love interest. But this movie helped me through tough times when I was younger, and I was going through different stresses, and I was always getting into trouble because I used to always get bullied at my old elementary school and get beaten up. And practically everybody beat me up back then. It was like a, I don't know, partying, beating up. They've all said sorry now, and I'm trying to be a good person. I'm trying to be tolerant. Most people that say they're tolerant tend to be intolerant, so I'm like, no, put my foot in that cork. But I accepted apology. But back then, I needed a movie like this for a relatable protagonist that didn't always win the day, got the girl. He got the girl, but it was only, like, technically. This one, he was, like, dating. He didn't even date her. His best friend, Harry Osborn, dated her, and Peter had feelings for her, and she had feelings for him, but he had to take the moral high ground. And I can relate to a character like that, because I've had to make that choice. A lot of my friends, even I have done the choice. It's been selfish. It's never. These two films in itself helped me out for tough times. Now, I actually used to really enjoy this one. Oh, yeah. Basically, these two are love triangle films, but I noticed at the time I saw it as great escapism, and the effects were great at the time. And so was the story, but best J.K. Simmons out of all of them. The same with J.K. Simmons, J. Jonah Jameson, you had the same issue you have with Perry White in the Superman films, the Spider-Man movies. Except for this one, it's a love triangle with an astronaut, Peter, and Mary Jane. But the astronaut kind of screwed it up himself, which is Jonah Jameson's son, which, yes, his son was an astronaut in the comics. And this one, it's him and his best friend. Okay, now let me talk about the third one. this film has its flaws, but and yes, I raked it underwater in my review, but it's a it shows darkness and silliness. It has a silly side to it. The black suit brought up Piers Morgan's silly side. In the comics, it was eating him alive. But at the time, this was the best kind of film we were getting. We didn't have the kind of films we have now with Marvel films and Netflix series and TV shows. I was just a young kid, I was like 7 or 8. You guys may hate me for it. This. Okay, let me show you guys. Those were, like, those three films are the ones that got me interested in the character, but I wasn't collecting comic books yet because I was only 8. That was around the year right after that I started collecting Spider-Man comics, and that's why I started to read them to get an escapism. And I felt like he was the most reliable. He had to try and help his family, maintain a healthy relationship, help his friends. Sure, he had bad luck, but he always kept on trying. Now, these films get trashed, but this film got me to get an awesome cosplay. That was much geeky talk. I could talk about that film. And this film gets trashed under the water. But when this film came out, I started collecting Spider-Man comics through the roof even more when they came out. And I actually enjoyed the dark. I wish they kept the tone they had throughout the second one, and they kept the good storytelling the way they did, but Sony got in the way and screwed that up, and then we got the music video edited edition of Amazing Spider-Man 2. But this got me to collect comics really in depth. I did collect a lot of Spidey comics and other comics, but Spider-Man has been the character I collected most comics, at least until 2016. I've cut down on collecting comic books lately. I've been taking a break and collecting comic books and focusing on other hobbies. Spider-Man has been a great hero to help me through tough times. So has Guardians of the Galaxy, that film. And X-Men Days of Future Past. I've watched that film when I'm not feeling my best a lot. But like, this hero, Spider-Man, and these two films. Actually, not two, three films. These three films, Spidey films, have helped me both get through tough times, get into cosplaying, and get deeper into comic books. Without these films, if they had never been released, I don't know if you've had Marvel, and I don't know if you know the same Angus Blu-ray techno geek reviews that you all know and whatever you think of me. And that's why I love Spider-Man, guys. Thank you for watching. My hair looks like shit. Just gonna put it up. Nah, it looks even worse. Thank you, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed that boring Angus talk.